Welcome back to West Texas View.
We were talking about group rights just before the break, and Stephanie said she had some more things she wanted to tell us.
Absolutely, because it is important when you're purchasing tickets for more than 8, I believe. I think the limit when you buy online is 8. But we do have group rates for some of our shows, which will give you a little bit of a discount. Uh-huh. And if even if we don't have a group rate, I know it's important for you to get your entire group kind of seated together.
Especially if it's young people.
Especially if it's young children or young adults. And so what you can do is at the building, at the Wagner Noel Performing Arts Center, we do have a box office where you can walk up and buy your tickets. That box office is open noon to 5, Monday through Friday. So unfortunately, we're not open on the weekends, but if you can get over to us on a lunch break, mm-hmm. It usually works pretty good. But there we have some box office attendants that can help you look at the seating chart, find that best section for you, and purchase your tickets. Mm-hmm. The other important thing about that is that you do save a little money when you come mm-hmm. to the box office. When you purchase online, there are convenience fees. Mm-hmm. Those are imposed by the ticketing company because, again, you know, you can uh-huh. do that from your home in your PJs, uh-huh. which is yeah. always good. And some people don't mind paying a little extra for that uh-huh. convenience. But if you want to save that, $6-$7 per your order, per your ticket, you can always come out to the box office. At the box office, you only pay an additional $2 that does come back to the Wagner uh-huh. Noel.
I've got a good story to tell you about a group that came over almost 60 miles, brought a senior retirement village group mm-hmm. over to a production, and they worried about where they were going to park their
wheelchairs,
big van and their walkers and yes. all of that. And so your staff was so helpful
Good.
In giving them directions where to park the bus and how was the best way for them to come in mm-hmm. with several of the people that needed handicapped accessibility.
We have a lovely core of volunteers. We have over 120 volunteer ushers.
Oh.
So for every performance, when you walk in our building, you're going to see them wearing black and white, and they're there to assist you, whether it's to get you to your seat or help you with a walker or a wheelchair or let you know where the restrooms are. They're there to make that experience a good one for you. And we are always actively seeking volunteers. And since this is running right around the holiday, I will kind of put out a call. We will have our next volunteer orientation in January. So if you're interested in becoming a volunteer, you know, it is some work, but we do have a lot of fun. Uh-huh. You can certainly call my office, the number's there on the screen, and I will be happy to send you an application and get you started on that process. We do lean on our volunteers quite a bit.
And that makes the whole experience so much nicer
Absolutely.
When you've got somebody right there.
The moment you walk in the door.
But one of the things I know is how handicapped accessible it
yes,
is.
Yes, it is.
And so someone will be able to tell them when they get mm-hmm. their tickets where to come in to get the closest to their seat.
The best accessible uh-huh. seat, absolutely. And, you know, always give your ticket attendant as much information as you can about needing that accessible uh-huh. seat.
Especially if you're buying group rates.
Especially if you're buying group rates. Or, you know, the holiday
is
a perfect time to buy a ticket as a gift for someone. So a lot of times we'll have someone that buys a ticket as a gift but forgets that that individual might have some needs as far as maybe they use a walker or an aisle might be better. So always try to keep those things in mind when you're buying that ticket as a gift, because then what happens is the show sells out and it's hard for us to be able to uh-huh. relocate them into uh-huh. a good seat. So, you know, do be mindful of buying tickets as gifts. We do sell gift certificates, which is always the better way to uh-huh. go, because that gift, they can then go pick the show that they like uh-huh. and they can choose the seat that uh-huh. they prefer. So gift certificates are a great way to go uh-huh. for the holiday.
And even if you can only afford a $25 gift
Absolutely.
Certificate, then they could just add
it goes towards
$12 or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Yes, ma'am. Yes. So it's fun. It's a great gift and a great stocking stuffer.
Uh-huh. That's an excellent idea. Do you have any kind of balance that you try to have so many family shows or children's shows in relation to all the other shows?
It's hard for us as a venue to be able to say
we're going
to
have
do
10%.
You know, yes, or you know, 10 children's shows, because it really depends on what's touring, uh-huh, what's uh-huh. Out. So what we do instead is just try to be mindful that we keep a variety. You know, that if we are doing, you know, quite a bit of country, that we start you know, really looking at those rock shows or looking at some children's programming. Children's programming, people ask us about children's programming a lot because we're always looking for things to do with the kids. Children's programming is a little harder to come by sometimes. But although sometimes a show may not be a child's program, shows like An Irish Christmas and A Christmas Carol
Vienna
are still a wonderful opportunity to bring the kids out and to have them experience just great live music and live performance. So, you know, I encourage families and parents to think about that as an option for the family, not necessarily that it's a kid show itself in nature or in title, but that it's still a family-friendly show.
Well, one of the questions I think that was called in after you were here before was that they would like to see some of our local area live programming brought to the Wagner Noel. So have you made any contacts with Permian Playhouse or Midland Community Theater?
Midland Community Theater and the Midland Odessa Symphony and Chorale did do a joint production at our venue last year.
Okay.
So they did three nights of Les Mis in the building.
Yeah.
So they, you know, we are always looking at those opportunities. You know, those opportunities are there and available to those organizations. So, but it's, we're a rental facility. So again, for some of those local organizations, funds are a factor. You know, they have to look at the rental and what they're, you know, what it's going to cost them to put that production on. And so for some of those nonprofit organizations, it does become a little bit tricky. But we've had a number of nonprofits. We've had a number of churches that have come through that have put together community concerts or outreach days. So you will start to see those on the calendar quite a bit.
Okay, great. Well, we're going to have to close our program now, but do you have anything else that you'd really like to tell everybody before we close?
You know, I would just say, look at the website, go to WagnerNoel.com, get familiar with our venue, and just see what we have to offer and see if there's something out there that you might like to come see.
But also, if they've got suggestions for programs.
Absolutely. My number and my email will work perfectly for that as well. We always love to hear suggestions from the community and what you would like to see at our building.
And I wanted to also remind our audience that you are celebrating this month and for probably the rest of the year, the third year anniversary. This facility has been open for 3 years. And one of the things we're going to be talking about in the programs ahead is how far we have come with Wagner Noel and how it has reached its vision. So we want you to join us next Sunday because we're going to talk about this. Thank you for joining us today. We'll see you next Sunday with another program.
Thanks for joining us for News West 9's West Texas View with Johnny Lou Avery. This has been a public affairs presentation of KWAB-TV and KWES-TV.